Hello, all you happy people. It's been a long time. Yes, I know. And I have a reason for that. One, I've been extremely busy since the end of the Orange Bowl, getting my degree. Yes, for most of you who know me, I've gone back to school. I was in school during football season, but it was a lot easier to just, you know, watch the games on Saturday and then comment and then go about my merry way. However, things started to pick up, and as of next week, I will technically be the first graduate of the Dan Patrick School of Sportscasting. I know, me. I'll be getting an associate's, not a bachelor's. I will be taking a couple more months of classes, because that's how much GI Bill I have left, and I figured, why let it go to waste? And I will get to cherry-pick a few courses here and there to help, catapult my career to the next level. I've done a little sports talk radio over the past few years, and now hopefully I can get back into it, whether it be here in Orlando or wherever the jobs may be. And that's the ultimate goal, to get back into the field that I love so much. But also, I don't know if I'm going to recap everything that's gone on in the past 3 months, But we got a new defensive coordinator. I know that's old news right now, but I'm really excited to see what Grinch is going to do. And just based on the little things I've seen so far, the clips we've seen on Twitter, and just the word around the campfire, I like the urgency. I love the energy. I love the excitement. And there's a no excuses attitude here. Like, this defense is going to get better with the guys we've got, and hopefully it will attract bigger names down the road. Unfortunately, we're losing defensive linemen here and there. Ron Tatum is gone, and he's going to a JUCO, which is, it is what it is. And Robert Barnes is a little dinged up, and, you know, the secondary has become a priority for Mr. Grinch, and hopefully he can, that's one area they need improvement on. I also like the idea that Ronnie Perkins is, you know, wanting to take that next step and become a big name in college football on the defensive line, because God knows Oklahoma needs it. But other than that, I will also be getting to see an Oklahoma game in person for the first time since in Norman 2008. It's the spring game, but that counts, right? So yes, I will be at the spring game, and for those of you that hate me, I will be wearing an Oklahoma hat and an Oklahoma shirt or, you know, jersey of some sort. And for those who want to say hi, I will be wearing an Oklahoma hat and an Oklahoma jersey shirt of some sort. And so come and say hi if you want to, or punch me in the face, because I know there's some of you out there who really want to do that. Please don't punch me in the face. Although I'm going into radio, I like to keep my face the way it is. Some of you would say that it would be an improvement if you punch me in the face, and there are days where I look in the mirror and I would agree with you. But let's try not to break any bone, shall we? Another reason I've been kind of gone, and you can hate me for this, but YouTube demonetized my channel for whatever reason, as something for duplicity or whatever reason that I was told that it was demonetized, and I said, why, what happened, and they couldn't tell me what, they didn't point out a video or something where this was wrong or this was bad, and it took them about 2.5 months to figure out that, like, I'm good to go. So be it, right? My theory is that it's either one of two things. It's either some of my highlight videos, which is odd, because that's never been a problem in the past. I think the issue is that I put up a lot of videos during the football season that were very similar, because you have this profile of me sitting here at my desk with a flag in the background, and their algorithm thought I was uploading the same shit. Which, to be honest, most of the time it is the same shit. So there you have it. But I don't know what the future of this channel is going to be, though. I've made this video before I took my radio job, because I didn't know, like, if this was going to be a thing I was kosher to do, and I'm kind of in that mode right now. So I'm not saying I'm not going to do videos this year. What I'm telling you is be prepared for the possibility of that not happening. So I plan to, as long as wherever I end up, whether it's here in Orlando, anywhere else in the country, if employees are cool with it, I will press on. If not, then you'll just have to follow me on Twitter and other various social... I know some people hit me up on Facebook. I do not accept friends on Facebook of people I do not know in person. It's nothing personal. But I like to have at least shook your hand in person and known you for a little bit before I just randomly add you to my Facebook. I have very few friends on my Facebook. Very few. It's like 30-something people. And they're all people I know in person. I've seen. So maybe with one or two exceptions. But there's reasons for that. Other than that, I'm looking forward to the spring game. And the one thing I haven't mentioned is, hey, we got a new quarterback, Jalen Hurts. And wouldn't it be funny if he won a Heisman Trophy? I think it'd be great because, hey, three in a row, and not only would you win three Heismans in a row, you'd break the record you're tied with Notre Dame and Ohio State. That's kind of been one of those things I wanted to see. If OU is not going to surpass like Alabama in fake national championships, unless you just make them up, then obviously you can do that. But you got to earn those Heismans. You got to get the voters to go your way. And, man, back-to-back years, that's special. Two quarterbacks, too. And how about both of them possibly going number one overall? Man, back-to-back Heismans, quarterbacks, same school, number one overall. That's going to be really cool to put up in the hallways and on the banners for recruiting for Riley. I mean, Riley's just kicking ass at recruiting on all levels. And I think Grinch is going to kick ass on all levels when it comes to recruiting. So, with that being said, I do have some personal family business to take care of while I come back to Oklahoma first. So I'm not going to be there all day at the spring game, but I'll probably show up. Hopefully, I don't know. I'll say early afternoon at some point. I doubt I'm going to be there for the concert because I don't really care about the concert like some of you out there. Because I'm not going for the country music. I'm going to check out 3 5-star wide receivers, Jalen Hurts, and just to see what Grinch is able to do with this defense. So, just checking in. Oh, and you know, one more thing I'll mention while I'm doing this video. I may or may not be making another YouTube channel. I may just put stuff on this channel, or I may make something new. This is not sports-related. So, for those of you who know, my username is Onikuno. I'm a huge fucking anime dork. Shocking, right? If you follow me on Twitter, you know all about it. Some of you have stopped following me on Twitter because I'm sure enough of the anime crap or the fact that I'm a dirty, nasty liberal. You know, that happens. So, I am going to do some stuff either here or another channel. I'll let people know who are interested. There's a handful of you out there who care. And I'm just going to talk about stuff from the 90s and just what it was like to be a fan before the big boom of the late 90s. And this is just stuff for me. I don't really plan to make it a big deal. I'm doing it for fun because I see a lot of anime content on YouTube, and unfortunately, most of those guys are douchebags. Just like I'm sure some of you out there think I'm a douchebag. So I figured, why not throw my hat in the ring? And with that being said, I'll keep you. If you're interested, I'll keep you updated. Follow me on Twitter at Onikuno. And with that, I'm out of here. And hey. See you at the spring game. Boomer.